I've been trying to get up the courage to come in here.
And you're willing to give up gambling?
Gladly. I would not have become a gambler had I not always fallen in evil companions who are always offering me supper beds.
Adieu, young man.
Thank you. It feels good just to talk to you people.
You just go right on talking to Sister Sarah, and you'll be all right. I'm glad you found us.
The Bible says, seeking ye shall find.
Very good. I wish we could reach more sinners like you. We are out every day trying.
Well, maybe you should try the nighttime.
How's that?
Being a former singer, I happen to know the best time to find sinners is between midnight and dawn. You might even try an all-night session against the devil.
A very good suggestion indeed. Thank you, Brother Masterson.
You're welcome.
Coffee so good? I can't understand why it isn't a sin.
A fine old gentleman. I suppose he sort of looks after you.
We look after each other.
And if one of you goes someplace, the other goes along.
Yes, of course.
Of course.
Here are two of our pamphlets I'd like you to read. They will give you a good deal of comfort.
Thank you.
And
I'm sure. Miss Sarah, I hope you do not think I am getting out of line, but I think it's wonderful, a pretty doll. I mean, a nice-looking lady like you, sacrificing herself for the sake of others. Staying here in this place, do you ever go anyplace else? Travel or something?
I would like to go to Africa.
That's a little far, but there are many wonderful places just a few hours from New York by plane. Ever been on a plane?
No.
Oh, it's wonderful. Thank you. I need a lot of personal help. My heart's as black as 2 feet down a wolf's gullet.
I will be speaking at the Thursday prayer meeting.
I need private lessons. Maybe we'll get at dinner or something.
I think not, Mr. Masters.
Sorry, just blossoming under the warmth of your kindness. Hey, that's wrong.
What's wrong?
That's not Proverbs, that's Isaiah.
It's Proverbs!
Sorry, no peace unto the wicked. Isaiah chapter 57, verse 22. Isaiah.
Isaiah.
There have been two things in every hotel room in this country. Sky Masterson and the Gideon Bible. I must have read the good book 10 or 12 times.
You've read the Bible 12 times?
Well, what's wrong with the Bible? Besides, in my line of work, the strangest information frequently comes in handy. I once won 5 G's on a parlay, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Tell me, Mr. Masterson, why are you here?
I told you, I'm a sinner.
You're lying.
Well, lying's a sin. Look, I'm a big sinner. If you get me, take the Bible to follow. And you need sinners, don't you?
We're managing.
Let's be honest. This mission is laying an egg. Why don't you let me help you? I bet I can fill this place with sinners.
I don't bet.
Then let me make you a proposition. When is this big meeting of yours? Thursday? I will guarantee to have 6 genuine sinners. And I will also guarantee that they will sit still and listen to you.
And what's my end of the bargain?
To have dinner with me.
Why do you want to have dinner with me?
I'm hungry. Here.
What's this?
Sky Masterson's marker for 6 sinners. If you don't think it's good, you can ask anyone in town. I owe you 6 sinners. I'll pick you up noon tomorrow for dinner.
At noon?
It will take us some time to get there.
To get where?
To my favorite restaurant.
Where is that?
El Cafe Cubana, Havana.
El Cafe Cubana, Havana.
Where do you want to eat? Howard Johnson's?
Havana!
What's wrong with it? The plane gets us there in 5 hours and back the same night. And the food is great.
I now realize, Mr. Gambler, that when you were describing the blackness of your heart,
hate God.
I don't hate anyone.
Except me. I'm just glad it's me personally, and not all guys in general. It's nice to know that somewhere in the world there's a guy that appeals to this argument. And I wonder what this guy would be like.
He will not be a gambler.
I'm not interested in what he will not be, but I am more interested in what he will be. How I care. But I'll stop. this the Biltmore Garage? Let me speak to Joey Biltmore.
Who's this?
This is Nathan Detroit.
This is Joey. What do you want?
I'm calling about the, you know.
The what?
The crap game.
The what?
The crap game.
Wait a minute. I got a customer.
Hurry it up, will ya?
That'll be $8. What did you say, Nathan?
The crap game!
Don't say that over the phone. Suppose the cops are listening.
I'm sorry, the dice game. Listen, Joey, is it okay if we use your place tomorrow night?
If I get $1,000...
You'll get it tomorrow.
Then call me tomorrow.
Listen, Joey, if you're going to take that kind of attitude, I'll find someplace else to have the game.
Then have it someplace else.
Where else can I have it? Listen, Joey, the dough is guaranteed. Would I lie to you?
Yes.
I'm getting it from Sky Masterson.
How do you know?
It's a bet. I can't lose. I bet if you could not take a doll to Havana.
Why couldn't you?
Because she ain't the type of doll that goes to Havana.
Then where does she go?
She don't go no place. That's why I know I'm gonna win.
Don't be so sure. It ain't a horse, it's a dog.
But Joey!
Nathan, there'll be no crap down here tomorrow unless I get my dough in advance.
Joey, you know me for a long time.
That's why I want it in advance.
Listen, I can't talk no more. I gotta go pick up Adelaide at the Hot Box. Is it okay if I just tell the fellas the game's gonna be at your place?
Not till I get the dough.
Okay, y'all get it. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
I hope you get stabbed by a Studebaker.
Thank you. there are certain kinds of dolls you can almost bet wouldn't go for a certain type of guy.
Nathan, no matter how terrible a fellow seems, you can never be sure some girl won't go for him. Take us.
Yeah.
Nathan, starting with next week, I'm going to be getting a raise. So with what I'll be making, I was wondering what you would think. Maybe we could finally get married.
Well, of course we're going to. Sooner or later.
I know, Nathan. But I'm starting to worry about Mother.
Your mother? What about your mother?
Well, Nathan, this is something I never told you before. But my mother, back in Rhode Island, she thinks we're married already.
Now, why would she think a thing like that?
I couldn't be engaged for 14 years, could I? People don't do that in Rhode Island. They all get married.
Then how come it's such a small state?
So anyway, I wrote her I was married.
You did, huh?
Uh-huh. Then after about 2 years...
What after about 2 years?
We had a baby.
You told your mother we had a baby.
I had to, Nathan. Mother wouldn't have understood if we hadn't.
So, what type baby was it?
It was a boy. I named it after you, Nathan.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, where is Nathan Jr. supposed to be now?
Oh, he's in boarding school. I wrote Mother he won the football game last Saturday.
I wish I had a bet on. Don't tell me he has a little sister.
All those years, Nathan. Mother believes in big families.
Okay. Just give me the grand total.
5.
Your mother must be a glutton for punishment.
So anyway, Nathan, now we're finally getting married, and it won't be a lie anymore.
Adelaide. How could you do such a thing to a nice old bride like your mother?
But Nathan, you don't even know my mother.
But I'll be meeting her soon. And what will I tell her? What will I tell her we did with 5 kids? Traded them to the Phillies or something? What are we going to do?
We could get married.
But marriage isn't something you jump into. Like a kettle of fish. We ain't ready.
I'm ready, Nathan. What do you think I got in this box? Nathan, what do you think I got in this box?
Sally's wedding shop. I can't guess.
It's a wedding veil. For 3 years. I won't show it to you because it's bad luck. Would you like to see it?
It's bad luck.
So anyway, I got the veil. Now all we need is our license and our blood test.
Our what?
Our blood test. It's a law.
What a city. First they closed down my crap game and now they want to open my veins.
Nathan, you're not planning to run your crack game again, are you?
Adelaide, how could you think such a thing? Why do you think I quit the crack game? It's because I love you, and I want us two to be the happiest married couple in the world.
Anybody see an earring out here?
I don't think so.
You! I'm all ready up tomorrow with Society Max, and he breaks it on account of your dopey crack game. Honest, Adelaide, I pity you. Oh, here he is.
That's my girl. See you tomorrow.
Yes.
It is too bad that a good businessman like Nathan has to go and fall in love with his own fiancée.
Jamie, that is his weakness. And we should be tolerant because I have heard that it is a worldwide weakness. Look. What's Planet the Roxy? I'll tell you what's Planet the Roxy. A story about a Minnesota man so in love with a Mississippi girl that he sacrifices everything and moves all the way to Biloxi. That's what's Planet the Roxy.
What's in the daily news? I'll tell you what's in the daily news. Story about a guy who bought his wife a small room in which would otherwise would have been his union dues. That's what's in the daily news. What's happening all over? I'll tell you what's happening all over. Guy sitting home by television set who once used to make something of a rover. That's what's happening all over. Love is a thing that has wisdom, and it looks like Nathan's just another victim. Yes, sir.
When you see a guy reach for stars in the sky, you can bet that he's doing it for some doll.
When you spot a giant waiting out in the rain, chances are he's insane. Is only a giant you meet for a chain. When you meet a gem made of lines of rim, for a flat that will flatten the toss.
I was
How do you do? General, I wish to protest the closing of this mission. I believe Miss Sarah could be a big success.
I'm glad to hear you say that, but I am not so certain.
A dollar will get you 10.
What?
General, might I make a suggestion?
Yes.
Why don't you come to this big meeting Thursday night and see for yourself? Don't you think that would be...